Hello and welcome to the assembly. My name is Waji and I'll be discussing the basics of NumPy. So for working with NumPy, you'll have to either install a pip install for NumPy. Otherwise, you can also install Anaconda and everything is included. And this is the website for it. So I already have Anaconda installed so I can work with Jupyter Notebook in this case. So let's make a new file, call it something like NumPy example or something. So it will be NumPy example, and this is just doing the basics. Okay, so first and foremost, we just import NumPy, and the standard is as NP, so let's just keep it as that. You can use anything you want, but people prefer to use NP in this case. So yeah, working with NumPy now. One thing to know about NumPy is everything has to be homogeneous. So the data types for all of the variables inside the array and all the data inside the array has to be the same data type. And otherwise, data cleaning will need to be performed. So now we'll be creating arrays in NumPy. So there's different ways to create it. First, we can just see the way to put zeros and ones inside our array. So we can put like maybe 10 zeros. And that'll just give us 10 zeros and let's print it. And that's 10 zeros inside the array. And it's a list inside that array. And we can also put ones if we want. So let's start putting ones. And we can print this again. So that'll be just ones, three ones, because we chose to put three. Then there's another way of doing it, which is more common, which is putting a list and then putting the list inside the array. So what we're doing here is, let's make a list, call it a list, and put a few values inside that. So that'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, let's say. Let's put 8 values. You can put anything you want, but just for example's sake, I'm just doing this. So now we have to put the list inside that array. So we're putting this list inside an array. This is a more usual and more confined way of doing this because this is how you normally work with data sets, which I'll show you guys later in this video. So now we just show G, and it does the same thing as that. I mean, not this, but like another way to do this is the one I'm going to show now, which is just doing the same thing. So we just put G like this and then just put the array inside 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, let's say, and we can just display G and it'll do the same thing as before. Now let me show you guys some important functions we can do in this case. So if you know Python, you'll know the random function, how you can create random integers and put them inside the list. So the NumPy also has a random function. One quick tip I'll give you on Jupyter Notebook is you can just press tab after dot and it'll show you all the functions that are going to apply. So you can look at the documentation and do it and see what you can do with NumPy. So let's put random and then we can put randint. Again, you can press tab and check what you can put. Then after that, let's put 10 integers. Let's check what we can put inside this. So again, you can press shift tab. And shift tab will show what all we can put inside the starting. So the low, high, size. So we'll just work with the values and the size. So let's put 10 values and the size of the array is 100. So if we just do this and make this like this. And just keep like this. I mean, let's remove this list and then just print z1 and just print NumPy array with the list inside that, which is just random values from 0 to 10, and there's 100 values in this. So what we can do with this is if you guys know Python 3, like if you worked with Python before, you'll know slicing, like the main string manipulation. So you can do that in NumPy too. which is taking from 0 to 10 and then put two values inside that. And we can also reverse it. So let me show you guys what happens. What do you think happens over here? So from your thinking, what do you think should happen over here? So I'll tell you guys what should happen. It goes from 0 till 10, and then every time it's a step of 2. So let's just skip this. This one, since it's 100, it can go to 100 also, and then every time it's step of 2. So you can work with the slicing, and you can also reverse the whole array. So we have the z1 array, and then we can also reverse it in the same way as that, which is just stepping minus 1, and then reverse it. So starting 4, 3, 7, as you can see, just reversing it. And we can also display elements. Like if you want the last element, you can just put 3, 1, -1, and it should display the last element, which is 4 in this case. And these are the basics. And now I'll show you guys image augmentation in this. So working with images. So there's a library, the ski image library. It's a bit advanced, so you won't really need to know this, but I'll show you guys what all you can do with NumPy. So let's take the ski image library and import. And I already have an image. I'll show you guys once I plot the image, but I already have an image in the same file as the one that my NumPy file is in. So I think it was called sample image. I'll show you guys the image in a minute, but the way to show this image, there's already been a video on matplotlib which covers this, but I'm going to use the same imshow function, which is in matplotlib, and I'll show the photo. So this is the photo I'm going to be working with. So what all can you do with this photo? You can find this images like these on Google to practice on your own. But PLT, sure. It's fine. So what can you do with this? So first you can find the shape of this. So photo.shape, which will basically show the RGB challenge of it. Again, there's no brackets. And this is just the RGB shape of it and the pixels. And we can also reverse the rows. So after reversing, it'll just turn upside down. The image will just turn upside down. And then this is just minus 1, and this will just reverse the rows of the image. PLT.it's I'm sure, and this is just reversing it, so just making it upside down. And you can also take out some parts. So the tar over here, we can take out, so it's between 200 and 400, the x values. I'm just taking out the tar from the image just to show you guys what you can do with it. And it's between, I think, 400 to let's say 700. So we can do that. This is the X and Y values that we can take. So PLT dot, I'm sure. And then this is the photo. And from there, it was what, 200, 400, I think. 200, 400. And 400 and 700. Yeah, it was this, I think. And it should display the tar. Yeah, it displays the tar, the top part of the tar. And this is all I'm going to show you guys for this part. I'll also show you guys a data set you can work on. Thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. And to keep up with our content, please follow us on our social media.